genuine and sarcastic. Generally ass-tastic.
I'm gonna roll under this one, if you don't mind.
No one to talk with, but I don't have to.
No, I think it just came on.
Hey man, I don't got no change.
Oh God.
Again. God.
Drunk.
I told you not tonight. Do you have a secret stash in there, or are you buying those when you go in?
What's that?
Beers.
Oh, it's all...
Where's awesome. The drop of?
It's all awesome. Dude, I don't know what that means. Are you buying those?
It's all awesome. All awesome.
whatever makes your mind at rest, it's all good.
I pull them out of my rolling lazy boy. No pigs.
You change that split sweat tail more.
Is that what you said?
I did it on accident.
Really, that's better.
Oh man,
I'm
not. It
was so solid. Watch out for my pet. I got one. One to walk with. I'm by myself. No one to talk with, but I'm happy on the set. You miss me, I'm
late. I'm home by late. Just me and my radio. Oh, don't you know, babe? And I'm saving all my love just for you. Don't go. Like Jack Horner on the corner. I'm going nowhere. But what the F-C-I-C-A-R-E-O, babe? You're worth the wait. Oh, Sally, nowhere to go. I'm home about it, just me.
Peter Jackson, click mine.
Yeah!
Playing, right? Still Peter Jackson in him.
Yeah. So that Fast Waller makes exploding heads. That's when he had some integrity with it. He was still exploding heads.
Here, hold that for a second. Don't touch the screen, but you're now the cameraman.
Oh, good. I have a thing I can do. And you people are talking, right?
I don't think there's anything I can ask. I've been a
goofy last year. They probably went off there like, they're done.
We died. And right in front of their eyes.
But this keeps it going. Do you post this later, or is this going? Oh, this is going.
We're live on the internet?
Yeah, this thing's going.
I've been shooting you all night.
You doing something wrong back there, girl? You up to
what time
something?
Is it?
Yeah. You up to something? She must be a POW, too.
I'm undercover.
Another POW.
Do you feel like singing a song? For a
good to be here at the end of that, the American drug war.
Well, I'm not sure. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna play the song for you. All right. I know you've been saying it all night. So I got out of it.
I love it. Not just Mike. I love it.
Thank you.
I love it.
Big Jim was a fisherman. They were lovers for a while. And they both carried on. Big Jim, he picked on a guitar like no one ever seen. And my grandma had a love affair. Her whole life with Jim Beam. Before the whiskey took their livers. Well, I was just a kid, and there's lots of things that I don't remember. And one thing I can't forget is Big Jim's guitar and my grandma dancing around the room, just sipping on her. Oh, I couldn't get enough. Well, them always falling down drunk, but them never falling out of love. Jimmy lived down in Bakersfield. He played with the best from honky tonk to honky tonk. His guitar would never rest, and my grandma would go watch him. She'd sit there at the bar, order up that bourbon, while old Jim picked on his guitar. Big Jim played all the songs that other people had wrote. He'd take my grandma home, fill the room with cigarettes, the smell of bourbon strong. Big Jim would play from the bottom of the bar. Grandma. Sipping on her whiskey jar. Oh, I
It's been many moons since I've heard old Jim play. I've been in my grandma's loving arms on a warm summer day. As I've gotten older, I've grown to realize that her body's a
sang it?
Yeah.
The way you sang big.
That's true.
Just like that. So I never like changed it. I could probably like, but that's just how it was.
It wouldn't be as perfect.
Sometimes it sounds like a cat dying or something. But I can't fucking
change. That was the melody, right?
No.
It was big.
That's awesome.
Oh, awesome. I know, but man, it ain't that fucking easy to hit all the time for a guy like me.
But you make it seem so effortless.
Yeah, because they're pretty neat people. I like them.
You know why? Because there's so much feeling.
Both are dead now.
Oh man, I was like, I think I was in fourth grade and Big Jim drank himself to death. And then I was in fifth grade and my grandma drank herself to death. So, I mean, it's a real fucking happy song, you know, but, I mean, they were just really fun to me. They were fun people. My grandma would have left. She would have walked away from any man if Willie McCovey would have fucking got on his knee and asked her to marry him.
Who's Willie McCovey?
He is a Giants player. Stretch McCovey. Yeah, black man, and he was fucking badass.
That's why they walked him intentionally, so.
Yeah. She would have walked the earth with Willie McCovey.
Intentionally.
And she let everybody know it, too. You ain't Willie McCovey. Yeah. I like you, but you ain't Willie McCovey.
Hey.
Thank you so much, man.
Thank you for coming
tonight,
Terry.
For sure. Love it here. See you on the other side.
The creepy side.
Hi, it was nice meeting you.
Oh, it was wonderful.
Seeing you. Are we hugging?
Well, I can't handshake only with one hand.
Just place down. Not next, though.
Nice to meet you.
Am I leaving? Is that
what I thought you were saying goodbye to people.
Yeah.
Are you actually still playing?
I mean, I gave no indication I was leaving.
I don't think 321 contact's coming on yet. Sesame Street's still happening.
Right.
Is that what the show is? 321 contact?
Yep.
An electric company. Electric company.
Electric company. Spider-Man.
Yeah, the Spider-Man was the. Oh, no. God. The Spider-Man was the
shadow.
Shit.
And I say,
the microphone's like right here. So anybody holding
right.
It is just doomed.
The
microphone for this.
Oh,
it's the worst.
Oh, yeah.
Ow! It sucks. Dude, I've ruined so many fucking videos.
Shwilly!
We watched that the other night.
Really? God.
I should pull the audio in and just see if I can edit it a little.
God.
Or something.
The anti Chad button.
Evolutionary.
Evolutionary.
They're eventuaries.
POWs are the evolution.
Yeah, they're eventuaries.
The evolution.
Eventuary estuary.
I did not think it was gonna be this cold here.
Uh-huh.
Awesome.
You get that free air conditioning, you can't shut it
up. Dude. It wasn't even that hot. Ever. Never once did I say, God, it's
hot.
Too
that
hot.
Cool,
right.
Man.
You're cool when you talk and when you sing, you wouldn't have thought you had such a bluesy kind of voice.
Oh,
wow.
Thanks.
And
I'll
tell
you
what,
that show you my mom tonight. And my dad were both black.
Awesome. That's great. Bluesy voice right there.
Yeah.
Great.
I would, wait, which part?
The one part.
Yeah, I was doing stuff I'd never done before.
Cool.
I didn't know.
Good
chicken. You did
brilliant.
You did a nice aviator look down too every now and then, because you barely see.
Well, I don't have my contacts in, so I didn't see the audience. I don't want to. I don't want to mess with them, like try and interact with them. So I just.
But you were it looked like you were your own world.
Yeah,
but your voice, I hear you talk,
yeah,
and then how
you
sing,
is the rest
like,
of
wow. You know, because when you sing, it's deep and groovy.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, that, you know, I haven't played a show in a couple of years, and when I went up there and I heard myself on the monitor, I said, man, this motherfucker can sing. This is going to be awesome. It's going to go easy. And I did.
I tell this story. He's got one of the greatest stories of New York. Tell him what you told me about New York.
What?
Well, can I tell you what you told
me?
I'll tell you the story.
He moved to New York for a while, and I was like, oh man, the professor's gone.
Okay.
And all of a sudden he came back, and I was like, tell me something about New York. He's like, oh man, New York. And he's like, yeah. What they're looking for is like here. So I brought a little here over there, and started going, you know. And nobody knew how to take here, but that's what they were looking for over there. And then some of the old timers who've been in the village for a long time said, man, you're the coolest thing we've seen come through here in years. And he's like, so I came home. I thought it was going to take me years. It only took me a couple months to be the coolest thing in New York.
I humbly do endorse that story.
And if you ever played, in New York? Any of the Grinch Village kind of thing?
Not really. Well, my band plays there.
I told you in confidence. Yes, you did. You were confident.
Yeah.
I told you that in great modesty.
Can't walk away with my heart. Every I'm just looking for some type of shoe, some type of boot. It won't burn out and run down, get filled up with hope. Anytime I roam in the town.
Great addition there too, Nate.
Yeah.
Part, right?
Get it right on. Charbonne.
Hey. Is that yours?
I wrote that like we were having a yard sale. Like watching all this shit go. Had enough. Like put everything in the house in the driveway. Quarter, yeah, take it. Go. Boom, boom, boom. I wrote that song while having a yard sale.
Wow.
It is an emotional thing in here today.
Mm-hmm. My friend Felicia in Santa Fe, the first song she ever wrote was having a yard sale.
Very emotional.
I'm getting 25 cents for that.
Mm-hmm. For that and this.
I was getting 50 cents, but I still felt cold that I brought everything in, and I said, no, there's no way you can have it.
That's like my pride and joy, and I'm giving away for a quarter.
Right.
And you just, like, say it, and it goes, and it's gone. And it's gone. Burn it all, that's what I say.
And you got a quarter.
You can park for 8 minutes in San Francisco.
Make it a shiny quarter, and we got a deal. We're going to take the peasant exit. Not fair.
I want to buy one of those. I want to buy a house.
It came open. Yeah. It's fucking, dude, put some shorts on, bro.
I got my shorts over there.
Yeah, you do.
You do.
Got them back, right?
They're on the sound booth.
Hippie pants.
Two cigarette warning. Well, we can stop. I'm not. We're in big trouble if I can't make it to the gas station. We might not. That's not about gas. It's about cigarettes. That's okay. I like to be interrupted.
I got a few menthols to spare.
Oh, yeah.
I love
them. I'll do.
Nobody know what this is?
I think I've seen that too many times.
Let's get that up on air, buddy.
No, we're not allowed to do that.
That's a butt, dude.
Quick.
Butt's not nudity.
Yeah,
butts are nudity?
Are
dude, I've seen butts on fucking Sesame Street.
Bart and Ernie.
Drop eight.
It's Butt and Ernie.
Why is that the first time anybody's ever said that?
Oh, don't, that's Butt and Ernie. Butt and Ernie.
I even had a lisp when I was a little kid.
Hey, Bert. Hey, Bert. Hey, Bert. I'd
say that all the time. I didn't know where the gold mine was in front.
Dude, I got shorts on and the wussy socks. How about those bacon stickers?
So Bert was the gay one?
Really? They both slept in the same bed, dude. I mean,
and took baths together.
Yeah, I mean, come on, dude.
Oh, they had separate beds. Baths.
They took baths together? Did they really?
He was even more of a weirdo than we could possibly.
I mean,
what happened? Yeah. When he did that, there were like 12 different jazz greats
that
made cameos in that Rubber Ducky show. Joe Williams. Count Basie, when I did that Rubber Ducky song. He had all these great jazz greats that showed in for it.
Willie, you never said the Count, dude. He was awesome. He was sick. Yeah.
How many empty beer cans do we have, kids?
One!
One!
How many licks does it take to get to the center, though?
I don't know. Ask Bert. Come on!
You get a point. I give you a point.
Dude, that was a win right there. If it only takes 1 point to win, that's all I need. How many licks does it take to get to the center of Ernie? I don't know. Ask Bert.
That part.
I'm good to go.
I really only have one legitimate verse for that one. I really only have one verse that I can confidently sing.
One Bert.
The Lord is one turn my world right around. Only takes one beautiful girl and I'm good to go.
I'm good to go.
Only takes one beautiful girl to make my night on the town. Feel like the night I've been waiting for. Only takes one beautiful girl to turn my eyes in the sand. Only takes one. What is it? Beautiful girl. Slip and slide with having fun.
Having fun.
Only takes one beautiful girl to turn my eyes in the sand. Get my words leaping from my tongue.
friend of mine.
Only takes one beautiful girl to make my night on the town. Feel like the night I've been waiting for.
And she's pulled the car around.
we got this whole song written, man.
No, it really hadn't. It's still just dangling in the wind.
No, it's written, man. It's written.
What's that? If I'm in a room where they're all taken, or just not the kind I'd take home tomorrow. Well, now that kind of rule ain't worth breaking. I'm not some fool that looking just to fall. Only takes one beautiful girl to turn my world right around. Only takes one beautiful girl and I'm good to go. It only takes one beautiful girl to make my night on the town. Feel like the night I've been waiting for. Oh, that could be something. Right. That was Freddie's verse in the car.
Where's Freddie? Really where's Freddie been?
Well, I don't know.
He's not finishing this song. So.
How does that one go?
Jeez. He's hanging out with Bert.
It goes,
I saw him in the bathroom earlier. Brings a new definition to slip and slide.
What made you think of that song?
Where'd Freddy go?
Oh, where'd Freddy go? Gotcha.
Oh, I thought I was shooting you. I wasn't.
Tonight this sad army lost another brave soldier to the arms of a beautiful girl. How I hate to see a man happy in love is like he's forgotten in the world. Leaving the drowning to the rage. We won't be pounding our fists again anytime soon. The orchestra will be empty, and I'll be howling at a hollow moon. Well, I know it was hard for him to say I'm staying, but that's what he said. I'm sure a part of him was a child again. But then part of him was dead, leaving the drowning to the rain. We won't be pounding our fist again anytime soon. The orchestra will be empty, and I'll be howling at a hollow moon. Well, now don't get me wrong by the words of the song. I'm not trying at dying alone. Still, it's a heartbreaking, breathtaking thing to behold. A man no more on his own. Believing the drowning to the rain. We won't be pounding our fists again anytime soon. The orchestra will be empty. I'll be howling at a hollow moon.
Ooh. Oh, 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 oh.
Swilly. Swilly.
Isn't that yours?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty.
Thank you.
You're a damn pure folks.
Right.
And these aren't things that I run across all the time. So I hope you take that as it's supposed to be meant.
Well, thank you.
I'll take it.
You call me Professor for a reason.
I done studied, Jim. Yeah.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
Well, it means you are indubitably. I was in the shower today, or not today. Last time I bathed was this month. I thought, if you ever want a lark, say indubitably like a valley girl. Indubitably. It's a lark, right? A lark?
A lark?
Why didn't that come out with the jokes? That was good.
Yeah, I had all this banner planned and then I forgot it.
It's not coming to me now.
So yeah, take this banner. Can you edit this banter into my performance?
Yes. Done. Highlight. What? Your jacket? That fuzzy one? No. I mean, I only have one cigarette left. Yeah.
Skivvies. You can give me the skivvies on it. You shark somewhere?
Oh, shining in your
face. Oh. Forget that. That's a line in there?
The
shit my pants line?
Oops.
Sometimes you gamble and lose. G and L, baby.
I thought
it was a fart.
Oh dear.
I thought it was a fart with all my heart.
I was wrong.
There was no relief. My underwear's in the street.
I came up here commando. As far as you know.
Wow. Can I go see it? I want to play that shit.
Did you play that?
Yes. It's right there.
That part when I wrote the template. Now everybody, now it's like fucking up everything. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I remembered it.
Did you make that up all by
myself? I made it up all by myself.
No, not all by myself.
Was that?
You had some lines.
That was in Colon, right?
Colon.
Here, hold this.
Water around the neck like pearl.
I got a pretty.
What's that?
That was my. Water around the neck like pearl.
What's your name, dear?
Bunny Liz.
Bunny Liz?
Yeah.
I'm Professor Matt Smith.
That's
not the same work. You're playing your ass off on that.
I got a pump on.
Did you ever listen back to you doing that? It, you sound so good on that. On that tape.
You know what? I like. It's not the best I can do. But
right. I'm calling dibs on harmonica in that tune. Trust me.
Johnny was on here.
What's that?
Oh, yeah, I don't know how long ago that was.
You're watching all the stuff? We're doing neat stuff right now right here. This seems to be captured.
Oh, man, did this just not happen?
Check the archives.
Damn.
This
is
not occur.
Just go through the archives right now. We're doing brilliant stuff. Oh, man. Don't know how to do it.
I'm living in the past. Sorry. Sorry, I live in the past.
You know what it is already? Figured out how? You keep home record?
No. I tell you how to get a poppy involved in this situation.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I just don't jump into evolution so quickly like this. I'm still stuck in the story a little bit.
We
don't even have a chat.
Right.
We do have friends that
are we talking?
Can download things.
Right.
Yeah.
We
got friends
on
the
download. Got friends on the download.
Wow. There it is. Last cigarette.
Dude, this is the last one.
Oh, yeah.
The last one ever.
This is called Pornogami. You'll love it. Take fucking notes.
Let's look away and then look back.
So good.
We'll be back.
I love that.
All I want to do is gotta look at how I'm doing, dude.
It's the only way I'll learn. How about we each look with one of our eyes and then we tell each other
what we're doing? Download it?
Wait, what if it's fucking left side? I'll go right eye.
What's your dominant eye?
I'm left side dominant. I'll go right eye.
I'll go left.
Left eye dominant, does that mean your right eye sucks?
I see a type of a cardboard robot. Oh, now it's turning into a
robot. Pull his legs, dude. Pull his legs. Pull them on the same time.
Pull them.
Both of them at the same time. No, the legs.
Yeah, the legs.
What
the there you go.
All right.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like a pop-up, dude.
I want to do it.
Oh, I got to put up your butt.
He's ready. He's
ready.
Right here.
I'm just doing what comes naturally.
Hey, Bert, hug on this.
I only had 3 times today.
Hey, Bert, pull my
legs.
Pull his legs, yeah.
Who the fuck's smiling at?
You did that? That's your
baby? Come on. That's my baby, dude.
Come on, brilliant, man. I'm a little speechless too. I always wonder where shit like that comes from.
and it's organic too. So they're Mexican.
Organic. It's organic.
Organic.
What this means is I'm a writer. I don't. Yeah, pull my legs.
It was really nice.
You too. Thanks for singing.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Just discounted everything I said. Yeah, it was beautiful. Does anybody want to go out on a date?
Yeah.
It works. You just have to ask. Oregon.
I'll
get you to do the border. What's in Oregon?
Going to Oregon.
You're going to Oregon.
Bye.
Bye.
Do you call about the fucking temp tax? I got a fuck ton of suits.
Okay.
You have some temp tax? Oh, tons.
Yeah, man.
So dinosaurs and fairies and
dinosaurs is all my girl.
Oh, dude, give me a shout, man. Or come on, when you come
I'll
over.
I'll be there. I'll be there.
I'm not mailing them to you. You gotta come. Yeah, it's right on the way to Oregon.
Ick.
What's your name?
Ick. Are you really going to Oregon?
I'm kidding.
To play?
Play, Nick.
You don't have to move big. No, I'm not. Steps feel pretty good. You got beer. You got some rolling left. You have rolling.
Always somehow.
Always somehow.
Brought to you by the letter R.
R.
And you're I have some home girls at back here.
But you don't say that on a webcast.
He did meet up with Jay.
What's
if he goes to Oregon, to Portland.
Yeah, you know Jacob.
You gonna roll a swimmy?
Oh, yeah.
You know Jacob Anderson?
I do know Jacob.
Of course you do. Yeah, of course. He's been on, dude.
Oh, man.
He's tweeting at you right now. You're not even
in. One night, me and the Cobb.
Tweeting your way.
When we first met in Austin. It was like I knew he was my ginger right off the bat.
That's cool. He was Nathan's Marianne.
I sure wish I got that.
Yeah.
I wish the tour would have lasted longer, but it was only
3 hours. No. Zing. Were people howling?
No, but the professor.
There were people howling.
There, I got a coconut radio in my pocket.
The professor was totally there.
That's right.
Yeah. Howling.
I don't get the howling.
Mr. and Mrs. Howell?
Oh, right.
Come on! I'm just starting.
Little buddy.
That's what you see all fucking Gilly's there.
Little buddy.
I like calling Gil. Remember the Globetrotters?
The episode? Yeah, dude, I mean, that show would never, it was like lost to me. Like,
right.
You can't ever get, like, they
you
never get on.
You can't get it?
Yeah. Like, yeah. You have to rewrite the same story every time. It's like Superman. Like, of course it's gonna end. You know, Hulk turned into the Hulk 3 times every episode. Come on. Yeah, they came to the island, dude.
That's brilliant.
Oh, they had
what was great is that they come rowing up.
Yeah, a globe. Hey, got a canoe. And it's always at the end, like Gilligan does some stupid thing, and then they're leaving. They're like, later, our plane that we built out of fucking
they turn around.
Oh God, they're already in the lagoon again. Damn lagoon.
Jonathan Winters will be here next week.
Should we go with the Globetrotters? No, Elvis is coming next week, dude. We gotta stay on.
Cast at Sesame Street.
Yeah, Sesame Street. Dude, Oscar's gonna be there, bro.
Always be there.
It's What's the thing with It sweeps, dude. We gotta stay till next week.
Sweeps. That doesn't happen anymore.
I don't think it. Do they do the thing where they used to give you the box, you know? God, I was talking about it yesterday.
The Nielsen,
do they do that anymore?
You ready?
I think they can know already what everybody's watching.
I remember
really?
Long time. I got a thing in the mail to be a part of it.
Still?
Yeah.
That's surprising to me. I think they would just fucking know what channel everybody's watching.
I got one about 3 years ago.
Did they still send a dollar?
They send a dollar? No, it was something better. Like, you get, like, free Netflix.
You get free Netflix, so you're not watching the TV.
Yeah.
So, do you watch TV or Netflix? Well, the Netflix are free. So. I don't actually watch.
Anybody really watch TV anymore? They used to give a crisp dollar bill in a little packet. I remember my girlfriend's mom got one, and she gave it to me because I was unemployed at the time.
So you got a Snickers?
No, I got a crisp dollar bill, and I never filled that out the thing.
Did they pay you, or did they just, like, give you free cable or something?
A crisp dollar bill.
No, that was what your
family was. That was a lot of money in those days.
Shit, well, because you could get a gallon of gas then.
I don't stop it.
That new shiny quarter.
Did I tell you it was crisp?
Yeah.
You're talking to me like it ain't crisp.
Crisp Kringle? Crisp not crinkle?
Yeah, crisp not crinkle.
Crisp crinkle. Dude, I got my pants starched, so when I walk, I got the old crisp crinkle going on.
No such thing. Hey, Jay Cobb was the name of one of the bad guys in John Wayne's last movie, The Shootist.
Really?
Yeah. Jay Cobb was one of the guys that he had the gunfight with in the final battle.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And I saw him in Portland and he said, hey, you know Nathan Warner?
No.
I've been making a point not to.
Was that this year at Southside, when they were at Southside?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because I went to Southwest.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. And then, he said...
We were there.
I'm going to,
Hi, Sierra.
Did you guys meet there?
Who? Strawberry.
Dude,
yeah, we popped our strawberry.
Dude, you were the first fucking stop. Like, I'm on Eat Playing Thursday. I'm going backstage, and I'm getting this fucking taken care of.
I'm ending this shit. I'm getting a good answer to the question.
And you look like Nathan Moore, I think. I think you are Nathan Moore. You seem like Nathan Moore.
Got me getting nervous before I got up there.
So I was in the porta potty and I made a mess of myself. That didn't come out right. That didn't come out right.
He came out in Alpha Natural.
Did you play? I didn't notice this, but my friend is like, did you play the same song twice?
In the same set?
Yeah, I didn't think
so. Somebody said that you.
Yeah, I knew that. Did you play the same song twice?
On that stage?
Yeah.
And
I didn't think so.
I would have done that.
I would have.
I think we need to go to the. I think we need to go back to the archives.
Yeah.
Who was saying that?
Here's the answer. No, why don't you watch the archives?
Maybe he played the same song the next day, possibly.
No. It was just a little while after he said it or whatever. And here's the impression of my friend.
So it wasn't real, because that was right after the fucking tequila jam. That's what happened. God, that shit ruined the whole day.
I watched the whole day, I was like, I don't know if I noticed it. Dean and Dennis.
Dean and Dennis?
What was he doing?
Did somebody else say it too?
Did he bring his Novocaine?
All I heard was Dean and Dennis. He might have been on the Novocaine.
No, you know what that's like.
Well, yeah, you didn't. I didn't hear that.
What's the shit? The gas, like in the dentist.
Nitrous.
That's nitrous?
Yes.
So if you do a slow, long nitrous thing, it'll put you out?
They usually
mix it with oxygen.
Yeah, with oxygen, and they do it with something else. Like, they're usually on, like, painkillers or something else, too. It's usually, like, a combo of, like, liquid painkillers and nitrous.
Look at him, fucking Opie, like,
Arnie fucking Tyler's fucking genius. I'll be in the morning.
Matlock. Matlock is a good sheriff.
Nice that you can, like, chewing on a cloud.
You're like, man, let me tell you about the time I was 10th runner up for Sesame Street.
Close, man. You ever watch Matlock, She Wrote?
Oh, God. What was her name? Lansbury.
Angela Lansbury.
She was the Grand Marshal of the Rose Parade one year. I went with my girlfriend's family. That should have told you we weren't right for each other. Right there. But the lady in front of us, so she drives by waving a big fucking thing, and she's waving to like 1,000 people every second, and the lady in front of me was like, oh my God, she waved at me!
She's still going doing theater. She's in her high 80s. She's
all right. Dude. No, who's the Golden Girls girl that did the fucking...
Betty White.
Oh my God, she crushed it on Saturday Night Live.
Oh, that was hilarious.
Crushed it. Did you see that one?
Right,
Jesus. Not fair.
She's got great comedic timing.
Old ladies being dirty is still funny.
Oh yeah.
Always funny.
Funny? We're all ladies.
Dirty.
Dirty old ladies. D-O-L's.
I'm a soft spot on
my heart. What spot in your what?
Yeah.
What, Bert?
Yeah. I gotta be fucking quick around Chad Galactic, dude. You gotta be beating me a lot of the time.
Ready, set, go!
I gotta get my chops in.
Yeah.
Drink these beers.
Probably only a couple minutes left of them.
Yeah. All right,
y'all. We got 10 more minutes.
Let me
know.
Well, that's cigarette pack really timed out.
Like, far
answer? Yeah. Because I got 24 seconds left, I think. What do you think? 20
Not
seconds.
Even.
2 seconds. We're out.
Hey, baby, dude. How are you doing?
That's the dude with the bacon stickers.
Ooh, may I have one of your bacon stickers?
They're in the van.
Okay.
They're in the van. Why don't you come with me? yeah, just climb in. Reach them. Face first.
Close your eyes if you want.
You bite on this if you have to.
If you all hated me, It'd be a little more like what I do.
That was good. I watched every watch.
Like, that was really good. Being a troubadour and like how like how nice strawberries and everything. And he's like, yeah, and if you all hated me, you'd get more of an idea exactly what I do. And you win this song,
it's gotta make a lead. Gotta make a lead. You and me. Dude, I gave one of the Jay Cox CDs to Adrienne. She better bring it tomorrow, but she was like,
like just Jay Cobb?
I don't know, whatever it was. Whatever he gave a bunch of us. Just like, here, listen to this. It's awesome.
What a cat.
Mm-hmm.
We fell in love with him. We want to marry him.
Where's he from?
Portland. God,
lost his phone number.
Dude, if you're going to Portland, I might go with you. I
want
to meet a hot dog, dude.
Go?
Yeah, I want to get a hot dog at Zach's Shack. That's all I've been dreaming about since we left Portland. Maybe now.
Should we go get Jay on the record?
Yeah, let's go get Jay.
I would love to go to Portland.
There's a lot of people we get on the record between here and there, too.
Oh, God.
A lot of Leaf Camp kids.
But you know what, man? Holy shit.
Holy shit.
That's a really great combo. Like, you and Willie and Jay.
Yep.
T-Tom.
What's
T-Tom. We gotta get him on the record.
Yeah. He's still holding strong, that viewer.
That was good.
That was right in the microphone, yeah.
That's a fart. Should I do it? No. I think it's a fart with all my heart.
I thought it was a fart. Dude, okay, so when you're sliding into home and your pants begin to foam, what the fuck does that mean? No, like, what is a foam, dude?
He's fucking cappuccino. Hey, it's a run, man. It's a run.
the run. We got the runs in, bro.
Oh, no.
When you're sliding in a second, you need to
get
in a second.
What? Well, yeah, because you were sliding, dude. You're just like germ flow from the dirt. I mean, that makes sense.
What is the cappuccino diarrhea mixture?
Cappuccino diarrhea. Oh, no whip.
What are the others?
I'll have a turd, no whip.
What are the others? Sliding in the first.
When you go into first and your pants begin to burst.
You're sliding in the second.
You're sliding in the third.
Sliding in the home.
Yeah, dude, when you slide into home and you realize you're all alone because you have like a turd pants,
when you're sliding in,
everybody should be jumping on you, but they're like, oh yeah!
Good night. Later, baby.
Good night. Did that happen to somebody? Was that like a famous moment in
baseball history?
You're talking about the Merkel boner.
Someone sharded rounding. What would you do if you took too big of a step? But you started sharding on
your white pants.
In your white pants.
Then all of a sudden you would be really famous.
What would you do?
You know, like how
what
they
would
do
you
that
do?
The end zone
would
dance.
You run the bases.
You have to. It's World Series. But you run funny like the guy. He does the touchdown dance. You know, he does like all like.
But he hit it out of the park.
It's like, you know,
it's all
sort of like this. It's sort of like this.
All the technicality.
Robin Ventura hit a game-winning grand slam and overran one of the guys that was on the bases.
Oh, yeah.
Because the other guy was celebrating.
And that nullified it.
Oh, God.
See, dude? But, dude, you could totally... Imagine if he ran so fast that he needed to get back to the shitter to, like, clean up or whatever, and he passed your guy.
Well, that's, I think...
Oh, you know what I would do if I sharded on the way to first after I hit a home run?
I would slide in the first.
Get your pants out. Get your pants out.
Man, it's all red and black.
Before your pants again.
You know, figure. Well,
yeah, but
let him figure that out.
Then you have to like do a press conference after, and everyone's like,
You remember when Pete Lyon?
Right. I guess that might not work.
And then they would ask you, why'd you slide into first? Well, because I just wanted to get in there.
And then slide into second and third. Then you've explained it. If you slide into all of them, then it's like a whole like celebration dance. You just like,
and then you take little trotty steps in between. You're like,
and then you come in for high fives and everything.
Instead of the guy that charted, the guy that slid in all three bases on a home run.
Right.
Cool dude.
Hey, anybody want to go out?
Super rad.
I can't from time to time, but I didn't admit, a good friend of mine. I was up to bat once when I was 12, and dude threw in my head, and I ducked down, and completely split my ass open on my pants that I hand sewed because I was so proud of my jersey that I got, my all-star jersey. I'm like, oh, I'll fix this shit. And I hand sewed them. And I just like, and all I had was a jock strap on.
Yeah, my whole ass
was hanging out while I'm at bat, and I had to fucking bat still.
Now that's 12. Is that pre butt hair era?
Two moons and a
smooth.
Kind of
I had a smooth.
A double moon and a side of fruit basket.
But then all of a sudden, I hit a bait, a single. So I'm on first. My ass hanging out. The only time I ever wanted to strike the fuck out. And so then I end up I'm running home, and I go in the dugout, and I have the bat boy go give me some napkins. So, because there's no patch, and my coach is like, ah, he's alright, you know, but my ass isn't really hanging out. So I put these napkins in.
Tape them.
I run out to right field, and the napkins stick to my sweaty ass, and go out like there's toilet paper, like stuff coming out of my ass.
One of them finds a way to pee.
Yeah, my pants burst.
When you went into first, your pants burst, dude. Diarrhea,
I'm home,
dude.
I'm all alone, man. You know
hey, high five! No!
The broadcaster, Steve Lyons, when he played for the White Sox back in about 1991, on a close play on the infield, he had a dive into first base. And he filled his pants with dirt as he dives in. And he gets up and he's kind of a mindy sort of fellow. And he gets up, he's happy to be safe, and he drops his pants in and says, that's one of them. And he's got his underwear on, and he kind of realizes there's 35,000 people out. What a great
like
moment.
Cleaning off his junk?
Yeah, well, I mean, if he, you know,
he's
he
a natural
he
move.
Had, he had, you know, his underwear on like this, but he pulled him down to get the dirt. A shitload of dirt out that he went diving in the first place.
Yes.
And there was just this funny moment where he pulls him down and realizes.
I'm sure there's a YouTube of that.
Yeah.
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 Now see, it's just that. That into the game, shit. He forgot where he was.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh.
They're all like waving. Tool left.
I didn't even think about it when I blew right at the door, basically.
I mean,
I could watch it.
Common sense, man. Right? Common sense. Right above
just
an hour.
I get all fired up about that shit, too.
You gotta break the rules if you don't break the rules.
When is this from?
I think it's old.
Really old. Dude, I sent him a text.
Johnny texted me and asked me what my favorite songs were on the record.
Yeah.
So he's gonna do some.
Yeah, I'm waiting to see that come in every morning I wake up hoping. Oh, they're putting down the
drapes. He's gonna be here for the Strictly weekend.
Oh, is he really?
Yeah.
Oh, we should just have him over. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's so cool.
You guys heading back down here tonight?
Yeah.
Well, it was a fucking pleasure.
These guys are awesome.
Thank you, Willie. Yeah.
Except for the shorts and the t-shirt, I'm great.
Those are great.
Wearing homo shorts?
Oh,
they are.
Right. Forge the crowd.
Come and knock on our door.
Come and knock on our door.
Oh, we'll be waiting for you.
Hers
and hers and yours. Company too.
That's a pretty sexy little song, man. Were the kisses or hers and hers and... Is that what it is?
Hers and hers. Yeah.
Well, he could never get in because the, like, porno raper
Isn't
guy upstairs.
Isn't that locked over there? Like, do we have to
yeah,
go?
Yeah, Larry was there? Like, hey, yeah. I sell used cars.
I sell used cars on a good day.
Okay. There's no idiots out here.
Well, there won't be.
There might be. Well, definitely. Not anymore. We're going inside.
Should I check?
Wait. Oh, check the stage? Alright.
Hey, good night, Will. Hey, Will.
Good night, man.
Not enjoy
the job. See you in the morning.
Oh, God, it stinks in here. Jesus. Getting the shorts on there. Yeah. I know. I took a ride on the saddle. Back on the saddle again. The molester saddles? Oh.
Depends on how you sit on it.
Sit on
it with gumption and you're going to get your fill.
Oh, I didn't see those.
Sit on them with gumption, dude.
They think the Cary Grant.
I'm good at it.
Yeah. No. Yeah, it's up there.
Yeah, they got the one that Cary Grant rode in the Western.
No.
Really?
Those are crazy space glasses.
What?
Yeah.
Someone gave them to me for free tonight.
Oh, wow, they're amazing. Say hi to the.
Are you filming or are you taking pictures?
I'm webcasting.
Oh. Sweet.
You want to watch it?
Yeah.
Somewhere. Somebody's got
something. We are webcasting.
Live
24/7 until October 12th.
Right. Punk Spa Sports.
Yeah, it's my turn to.
Punk. Sports. Action sports. Well, I don't know what that is either, but. Right.
That's great. We're all here.
We're all here because we're not all there.
So yeah, all the information that they'll log on is on here. It's on this website.
On that one, okay.
Yeah, come say hi. We're live till October 12th. Yep.
Happy night.
You have a good night.
Do you have a guy's version of this?
me?
Do you have a guy's version of that?
This one's been in for like 2 months. This one.
Just ladies? No, yeah, I think you got some dudes down there.
That's a dude, that's a big woman.
They're all the same.
They're all ladies, the extra large?
This one says
ladies. Oh, that is a lady. Hold on 1 second.
Oh, man, I thought that was perfume. Oh my god, I thought you were a freak.
Your eyes smell
so good. Your eyes smell so good. Oh, Bert.
Hey,
Bert.
It's like a mint in your eye. I put it
in
my
eye.
She's like, ah!
Is it really? Does it smell minty?
No, it doesn't.
Oh, oh. I was coming in for a sniff. I was like, get out of here.
Who would want a mint in their eye? Who would that hurt? It smells good, though. I got allergies. Okay. What size?
Larger?
Man.
I have an XL.
Okay, I think I
have
an XL. There you go. I had another one on. Damn, that man is smooth.
Oh, wait, no.
Now
I can't see.
Here, Liz, hold this. I'm gonna go get the car.
I'm fucking. I love it.
Huh?
Is that a strawberry fest shirt?
No, it's a Knight's Ferry.
Oh,
population
Ferry.
98.
I think it's on the shirt there.
I'll be telling stories of Knight's Ferry.
Thank you.
We got it.
Yep, write it down.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you guys very much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Good old AM radio. God, I miss the sound of that kind of voice right there. Sheetherfest. I feel so bad as a storyteller because I got really confused because I had heard that story. But I had Sheether on the webcast with a nice microphone and was talking to him. But I was confused because of the Heather Fest thing, because I thought that this whole fest was in his honor until it was called Heather Fest, and then I got confused. So instead of being like, I was talking to Sheether, and instead of being like, oh my god, this is so amazing that this is happening, I was just like, so you have, like, I mean, you have something to do with this, don't you? You know, like it was
Maybe.
Hootin' and a
Get
Down.
I think we did that.
Yeah.
For sure. Were you here for the other days?
No.
They did it all weekend, right?
Yeah.
How was the other days? Were great, weren't they? Very last night was magic.
It was great. Oh, shit.
I took a nap last night,
cool.
And I set the AM for PM.
Cool.
I took a nap before. I understood that happens. Seems to happen to AM for the PM.
It was so good they don't let me back in the community. Yeah.
That's a win.
Yeah, that's a win. I got to W there. Yeah, we're 2-0.
You're 8-6.
Right?
I love that. Good.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
Get a card.
Oh, you can have a card.
One of these has writings on it. I don't know what this is.
Yeah, no, I checked out your website there the other day for a couple of minutes.
Were we on it?
I didn't get the live hookup. Just a couple of minutes. I was
guy
on, but
who took
I got
photos
it at, I'm definitely going to check it back out, especially since the project you're going.
Good.
Yeah, it's really,
cool.
Yeah, it's really happening.
Yeah.
Really is.
I think it's awesome, really.
It's really fun.
It's really happening.
I got a lot of, just today, I got like a 20 files to mix into the scene.
I know. Hey, I'll keep you busy for a couple of days.
Yeah.
At least.
And this great percussionist. You ever heard of Sean Hayes?
I don't believe so, not yet.
He's amazing.
You should get Sheila E.
His drummer is coming in tomorrow for an actual percussion session.
Oh, nice.
It's going to be fun. Percussion sessions.
But Sean, he's amazing.
on.
No lush sounds.
Yeah,
I mean,
but just like an egg shaker,
oh, really?
Man.
Like
coming in for a percussion session.
Hey, Bert, come on over. Play percussion?
I love percussion over those on tracks.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah, we just did all our drum tracks on our next one, and Aaron, he's a good drummer.
Yeah, for sure.
You guys got it going on.
God.
Yeah, we gotta get you to High Sierra.
Oh, yeah, I don't know how to even do that, though. Seems like a mystery.
He knows the
thing. You have to, like, unlock the secret.
I think you just start with 1 foot doing one of these.
I'll definitely put in a big word for you there.
Yeah,
I don't know what it will do, but I know all these guys.
Yeah.
You're way back at this point.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, Nathan's the mayor.
I'm the mayor of High Sierra.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, a little full. You would think.
Yeah?
Man, don't get me started, politics.
Oh, I know, man. I might be the new announcer.
It's really just a pretty face.
I might be in there, too.
Right,
you know,
exactly.
Puppet.
We're
kind of
getting into the, you know.
Yeah.
I heard you on the radio.
Yeah.
You know,
I got a face for radio, baby.
Yeah. That beard comes in airwaves.
Hey, you're the mayor of Strawberry, right?
No.
No? Who is?
But he's
not
old.
You. Who the fuck is? I think it's you.
Yeah, dude. You're just sort of
old. It's you.
Yeah.
I'm
just a
mean
mayor.
He is.
Yeah.
I'm making a fair assessment.
Like a clean ruling.
It just happened right
there. You forget your umbrella.
Oh, that's nice. I'm thinking.
I'm turning my lady.
I knew you
left your umbrella behind.
If you want to be adorned, I got some stickers in my car. Crawling head first.
Yeah,
that towel? Yeah. You might
want to
use that.
Yeah, need it.
Who's at it?
The fortress situation now where you kick it and it lands on my head.
Okay.
And you preload.
That boot shoots off into my teeth.
Oh, no. It's going for Chad's head.
Yeah. Hack me, hack me. But I gotta act like I don't
Chad's
know.
Chad's going. I don't know, Chad.
Keep it casual. Oh!
I got it.
Dude, I'm good at with the cone.
Okay, I'm gonna go like this. I'm gonna do like a
little Missy Elliott thing.
Yeah.
Flip it for reverse.
Scared the shit out of the house.
Oh!
Oh, man.
Liz, if you had a boner, it would have landed on it.
Yeah, Liz, get your boner on for once in your life.
Put your boner on.
I already got my legs.
Or, put it flicking under your knee.
Oh!
Dude, wait, did you see your pants before you were diving into the face?
You had that on your head.
It was for a second. Did we get it?
Better fit than
I think
ever.
Maybe. Oh, my God.
Remember that time I got that wiener, Mama?
Oh, yeah. I had this heat shooter, like, on the tire.
This is the jackass thing.
And he bought about 100 wieners. Hot dogs.
I had this idea that he would be like, you have to be out in the field, and I would sling the heat shooter with a hot dog in it.
About 150 feet.
No, it's just a wiener.
It's about 150 foot wiener sling.
And so it'd be like.
Jumping up and it'd be like.
And they were getting fat lifts about it. They were getting fat lifts.
I got a fat lift from a wiener,
man. Really, you don't want to say that. You don't want to get burned, dude.
Hey,
man,
we're,
I came
hey,
out
we tell the truth.
Fat,
we tell the truth and we don't walk away from
so
it.
So then we were.
He gets down to the last pack now.
We were all pretty done with wieners in the face, dude. It was a lot of fun.
But what they don't know about me is I don't tire of wieners in the face. So down to the last pack, he puts this shot
on it.
I was in the field with you. I was next to you. I was trying to get the wiener. Somebody wiener slung. And it was up like this. It was a perfect shot down the center. And I was like, ready. I'm on this side, and the professor's like over here. And then the professor just goes,
I go in a full double back, Willie
like
Mays,
and he's falling, and the wiener goes, what? And he's falling on his back, and the game is fucking over.
We don't have a TV, but I hear it was on ESPN Highlights that night.
And he was falling, I saw the whole goddamn thing. Never forget.
I'm sick in.
Man, it's good to see you guys.
Oh my god.
I hope I see you again soon, because I'm just going to be thinking about wieners.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
See you soon.
Yeah.
Have a safe.
I will see you soon.
Yeah, take care of Bert. Sorry, Bert.
Thanks, man.
Pleasure was a pleasure.
Bunny baby, you're a dollar and a half.
Aw, thanks.
Have good travels, okay?
You too.
Hey, good travels for you.
Au revoir.
Yeah. We gotta run into each other again, huh?
As soon as possible.
Dig, dig. Yeah.
Hey, hey, Fire Laurel.
Really?
I think.
Well, that was a special little outing to Knight's Ferry. So good. Great people, great music.
I was almost walking to that girl at the end.
Which one?
I was walking to the hot one.
Which one?
I was sitting at the bar all night. Well, I just gave the card to, and then she walked out and was staring at me. I'll call you tomorrow. Oh, can you come back to Knight's Ferry and pick me up? My pants are ripped. Come on! Holy shit.
I like this guy.
I love that guy.
That's so good. Watched a movie. He could have been in a movie I watched last night. It was called The Penthouse that I watched. Oh, yeah, baby. Calculated.
We came that way.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Are
you plugged in?
I'm trying to see it.
Trying to see it. Oh.
Maybe we got syrup in a hotel.
Yeah, we will. That was really fun.
It was.
Do it again.
Do it.
Are we good?
Yeah.
Okay,
Yeah, maybe the cast was just so intermittent for a long time tonight that it never got a chance to congeal.
God, I miss it.
What's that, what?
Congeal? I couldn't believe it. The whole time. And I was so bummed because I just started a Facebook and the shit died. That shit, dude. The fucking killing a cat story.
Oh, yeah?
The first guy Willie smoked a cigarette with was a Capri. And that dude went to prison for trying to murder a grandmother.
Wow.
Yeah. And he was like, yeah, he was always kind of a little weird. Like the time he killed a cat and put it on somebody's grave and wanted me to come look at it. He was like, man, I really like smoking cigarettes with you. I'm not into that, though. Eat something, right? Eat pigeon?
What's that?
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. It's weird to play after listening.
Yeah. You haven't played in a while.
No.
Like, really?
Yeah, Davis is so different.
Right.
Strawberry. Was it, but that felt weird too. It would, it definitely got me, I definitely like specifically was having thoughts today about how like, oh my god, it's like so cool how you, when you, when you're touring or, you know, playing every night and stuff, like what that does for your playing is so cool. Like, and each tour is always a little bit different. Like you grow in a different way or you discover something new. But you sit on your butt for a month or two, and or, you know, if you're not playing like that, performing, you're fine. You gotta start back again. What's that? Yep. I can hear it when I listen to like old Fiascos, like two-thirds of the way through or something, and I really start finding all these things. What's that? What'd you say? Zambricky?
Yeah.
Who is that?
That's his friend from home.
I'm gonna play it.
He's the one who tried to set us up in Nashville.
Right. Left some on the table.
What?
Collectively.
I ate the like.
You ate yours anyways. Filled yourself up.
I just wanted them so bad. They were terrible. I ate like 6 of yours. And I was still pukey, and then I ate that mott stick. But it was like so cold. And it was like burpy as fuck.
This man needs a hot dog.
Oh my god, dude. I like eating hot dogs. What the fuck?
I can't believe I got a I Heart Bacon and I Heart Hot Dogs. I got that on the same day. I got an I Heart Bacon and an I Heart Hot Dog sticker from two completely different people.
Now you just need an I Heart.
That's weird. I did too.
Thank you.